This is an original American poster from 1904 advertising the New England Fair in Worcester, Massachusetts, a precursor of the Big E. This poster was creased, ripped, and folded, so we gave it a poster fix.
Hi, I'm Chris. Welcome to Poster Fix. Linen backing is a process where we take a vintage poster and mount it to a piece of acid-free paper and cotton canvas. It's an archival process, meaning that it's good for the paper. It helps it last longer. It helps to neutralize the acids. It flattens out folds and creases, and it gives us a base from which to perform more restoration, like paper fills and color retouching. So that's what we do here, and today we have a fantastic and interesting project to show you.
To tell you the truth, for a poster that comes from 1904, it's in pretty good condition. There's a bite missing there. There are rips around the edges, as you can see, and little bites along the edge. But look at this. It's in pretty good condition. Copyright 1903 by the Fair Publishing House in Norwalk, Ohio. The printing and the lithography is quite beautiful. Anyway, we're going to linen back this poster, but first we have to prepare a screen. This is wheat paste, and we're putting wheat paste all over this acid-free paper, because this is the acid-free paper that's going to get the poster mounted to it. We lift the paper and put it up onto the canvas, cotton canvas, made in America. This paper is also American, and it's acid-free. Hercules puts the screen on the table, no easy task, and he helps the paper expand by rolling it out and getting rid of all those excessive air pockets. And so that way we have a screen prepared to linen back the poster to, and that's what we're going to do now. He's spreading wheat paste right onto the acid-free paper so that we can lay the poster down onto it, and this is the poster we're going to linen back, the greatest fair in New England.
You want it the other way?
What is a state fair? A state fair is an annual competitive and recreational gathering of a U.S. state's population, usually held in late summer or early fall. It is a larger version of a county fair, often including only exhibits or competitors that have won in their categories at the more local county fairs. State fairs began in the 19th century for the purpose of promoting state agriculture through competitive exhibitions of livestock and display of farm products. As the U.S. evolved from a predominantly agrarian to an industrial society in the 20th century and the more service economy of the 21st century, modern state fairs have expanded to include carnival amusement rides and games, display of industrial products, automobile racing, and entertainment such as musical concerts. Large fairs can admit more than 1 million visitors over the course of a week or two. The first U.S. state fair was that of New York, held in 1841 in Syracuse, and has been held annually to the present time. The second state fair was in Detroit, Michigan, which ran from 1849 to 2009. Events similar to state fairs are also held annually in each state capital in Australia, known as royal shows. Australian royal shows are organized by state agricultural and horticultural societies and are described further in the agricultural show article. This poster is from 1904 and is specifically from Worcester, Massachusetts, which is not where the Big E is known to have developed. What is the Big E? The Big E, formerly known as the Eastern States Exposition, is billed as New England's Great State Fair. It is the largest agricultural event on the Eastern Seaboard and the sixth largest fair in the nation. The Big E is inclusive of all six of the New England states: Connecticut, Maine, Massachusetts, New Hampshire, Rhode Island, and Vermont. Each of the New England states is prominently represented at the fair. Located in the Pioneer Valley of Western Massachusetts, a short distance from the Memorial Bridge spanning the Connecticut River, the Big E is held every autumn in West Springfield, Massachusetts. Each year, the fair opens on the second Friday after Labor Day and runs for 17 days. The first Eastern State Exposition occurred October 1916 in Springfield. What about 1904? Apparently, this poster you're looking at for the New England State Fair precedes the creation of the Eastern States Exposition, or the Big E. The Big E has presented the finest livestock, the most innovative commercial, industrial, and artistic developments, and the highest caliber of varied entertainment to the people of northeastern United States for more than a century. For more than 1 million people now attend.
We're going to let this poster dry on the screen for a few days before we do the restoration and then trim it down. Don't go away, we'll be right back.
We're back in the PosterFix shop and I'm about to commence with doing the paper fills. First, I'm going to sand the areas where the ridges are high so that when I put in the paper pulp, it will blend into the original paper quite well. The New England Fair is an expression of agricultural roots. There are many open show exhibitors, educational displays and attraction. There are many livestock displays at the New England Fair. There's a coliseum that features daily horse shows, another complex that has livestock and other farm animals, including goats, chickens, pigs, and sheep. Other animals, such as those found at a petting zoo, are in a circus area. Small-scale dog and pony shows are regular features. As far as food goes, many foods representing New England cuisine can be found at the New England Fair, along with traditional fair foods like fried dough, corn dogs, and lemonade. Aside from the state houses, food sellers can be found throughout the main vendor areas and around the perimeter of the fairgrounds. And now a few days have passed and I'm trimming the poster down off of the screen so my wife Oki can take over the restoration project. She's going to go in with more paper pulp and do some fine tuning to the paper fills that I had already put in and add some more that I have missed. That corner actually never got a paper fill when I was working on it. I don't think I noticed that it needed one. So this is our process. Now she's taking the burnisher. She's taking a piece of plastic and a flat object to push down the creases to make it flatter against the linen backing because there are still ridges and creases caused where the paper is either ripped or folded or creased. And now she's taking the sandpaper and continuing to fine-tune the sanding to make sure that the paper fills are very smooth against the poster. And once she's done that, she's going to take water reversible gouache and begin the recreation of the missing parts of the image.
Well, that about wraps it up for today's edition of PosterFix. As a side note, I strongly urge you to use UPS when sending me your vintage posters. They give the safest, best service. And you can never pack a poster too well. Double packaging it is even better. Make sure to include a sheet with your name, shipping address, phone number, and email. That way I'll know who the poster is coming from and where I have to ship it back to. That helps me a lot too. I look forward to seeing your posters, and I'll see you next time at PosterFix.